The Bears have it going their way, and the Steelers need to get it going today. As we welcome you to snowy Pittsburgh, Heinz Field is seen today for what should be a grueling defensive battle between the Chicago Bears and the Pittsburgh Steelers. Charlie Batch becomes the backup quarterback. On second down, the screen pass to Willie Parker. Parker gets loose into Bears territory. And Willie Parker almost gets by everybody. And he is tackled after a huge gain of 45 yards by the strong safety.
Chicago Bears, one way to counteract that, the screen pass. Willie Parker slips out to the outside. Here comes Jeff Harding, 64, gets the key block on Brian Urlacher, takes two guys out. Now it's a straight shot down the field. There's Jeff Harding, two guys, Lance Briggs and Brian Urlacher, and then Willie Parker turns on the Jets.
And the Steelers threaten early. First down on the Bears' 22-yard line. And they give the ball to Parker, gets running room, spins away from a defender and gets about 8 or 9 yards on first down. Checking in for the Steelers. Expected to see a lot of action, and here is the pass to Hines Ward. And Ward gets to the 5, still on his feet, scores! Touchdown, Pittsburgh! 15 yards for the score.
Hines Ward's coming around in motion. They fake the little reverse to him. Then they flip it outside on the screen. Watch the effort by Hines Ward. The thing about the Pittsburgh Steelers receivers is after the catch, they are physical runners with the football.
For only 68 yards, and it's first and goal at the 2. Two tight ends, and here is Thomas Jones. No way, and they'll even lose a couple on the play. Second down and goal, and Orton gets slammed by Clark Hagans for the loss. It was second down and goal, not third and 3.
You get down here, you open up your formation a little bit. You're not in a traditional goal line offense. You're booting it out, but you got a guy right in your face. Clark Hagans is waiting right there for Kyle Orton when he turns around. Nothing Kyle could do with that one. Lucky to hold on to the ball.
Now it's third down and goal at the 11. So Kyle Orton already has improved on his passing from last week, but the Bears looking to get a touchdown, and there's a pump fake by Orton, and the pass overthrown to the tight end Desmond Clark, and the Steelers hold on third down. Out of the shotgun for Ben Roethlisberger. His quick toss, slant, first down to the 46-yard line, and Cedric Wilson last week when Rashid Davis had his problems.
He's been catching the ball well. He's just been fumbling it on contact.
And here is Wade. Ball floating. Wade at the 16-yard line. Runs into his own blocker and gets driven back. And they'll call the forward progress at the 19-yard line. And here's Jones. Close. And they may need a measurement. We'll see where they made the hit. Larry Foote.
You didn't have to run. Very important down the field there.
Famed orange sleeves as Willie Parker runs for the first down. He's had a great first half. Hillenmeyer on the tackle after Parker picks up 11 yards. And Roethlisberger getting pressure and on the screen pass for Ron Hayes. Spinning away, and Hayes is going to get the first down as he gets into Chicago territory.
Brian Urlacher, 54, there he goes into the middle by the emblem. Now he's going to have a chance to get Veron Haynes right there. He gets blocked. He had another one missed earlier. They had him at the original line of scrimmage. That was probably another 10 yards.
And you would know, having played them, second down and 2, first back through.
The fullback.
Kreider, the fullback, and Kreider inside the 30. That one is for Moose. The fullback carries Ryan Urlacher, the tackle after 12 more yards.
Willie Parker, Veron Haynes, and all of a sudden you slip 35 in there real quick. He even gets a trap. That's awesome.
Now all he has to do is catch a ball. He'll really be happy, almost.
I already had a catch.
7-3. First down on the Bears, 29. Play action. And the pass flagged down is caught by Cedric Wilson. And Wilson is down at the 12-yard line. The 12. And here is Parker trying to go outside left. Parker going in and no signal given, and Parker is out of bounds just inside the 1-yard line. First and goal at the 1. And they give it to the bus. Touchdown Steelers. This is a totally different team than the club that lost the previous three.
Now, I was standing here about 8 yards behind Brian Urlacher. One thing I saw with the Chicago defense was when you're on the goal line, you're down here, you got to go and stand people up. But right there, Green, number 43, has to get involved in this. The play does not stop until the whistle's blown.
Down in 10 at the 34. And Orton with a quick pass, and it's incomplete. Musin Muhammad claiming he was interfered with. No flags are down. Ike Taylor on the coverage, and fourth down again for the Bears. Haven't gone to Berrien yet. Orton looking his way, and the pass, and it's knocked down. Nearly intercepted. Deshae Townsend defending against Berrien.
Throws, but I agree, Dick. They've got to get some points going in at halftime.
And throwing on first down, Kyle Orton being chased down, and he's going to be tackled after a gain of one by James Farrier.
Get that ball down the field.
Second down and 9. Deep drop this time, and the ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage. Only one timeout left for Chicago. Watch out for the blitz, and Orton gets rid of it to Deshae Townsend. Third down and 9. Bears are out of timeouts. Kyle Orton with a big third down pass, and it's incomplete.
Had a few breakdowns here and there.
Gardocki punting. Bobby Wade. That deep, great kick by Gardocki, and Wade bobbles it at the 5, picks it up at the goal line, and puts the Bears in a big hole. You got to credit Gardocki with a lot of that. Just stroke it in the cup is all you have to do.
Exactly.
Ball on the 12-yard line, Thomas Jones. And the Steelers are right there. Clark Hagans leading the pack. Second down and 11. And here is Kyle Orton's pass, bobbled and nearly picked off. And I tell you, if it weren't for Desmond Clark on third and 11 with the Bears on their own 12-yard line, Tony. And there is Kyle Orton, and he's sacked at the 3 by Joey Porter.
Joey Porter's at the top. You're putting a fullback on him, but you're having these guys come this way. That puts him on a huge island. And Joey Porter is one of the better pass rushers. Look at all the room that he has to work against Jason McKee in that situation. You've got to know at certain times you don't want to leave your fullback or your running back on an island. We always talk about the tackles.
Second down and 5 on the 47-yard line of Chicago. Here's Parker again backing up, but gets the second try. First down for Parker and out of bounds at about the 40-yard line. And the Steelers with the typical third down formation out of the shotgun. Roethlisberger with loads of time. Caught by Antoine Randall L. First down inside the 20. A big 15-yard play for the Steelers.
Ben Roethlisberger has all day in the pocket. Number 82, Antoine Randall L. releases up the field, just sits it down in a little soft spot right there. And we talk about these zone coverages when the guys are dropping back. Instead of blitzing, you're going to drop back and play zones, and there's little windows. That's exactly what we're talking about.
And the 18, and here's Roethlisberger's pass. And trying to hold on, and the catch is made by Quincy Morgan. Jerry Azuma all over him, but Quincy Morgan made Pro Bowl last year. Faneca went to the last 4 Pro Bowls. Second down and goal. They go to Bettis again. Bettis gets hit. Still driving. Touchdown! And it is his second touchdown here. 5 yards.
We've talked about missed tackles, but these are just broken tackles by Jerome Bettis. Bam! Bam! Well, I tell you, some guys, you get down in the red zone, down by the goal line, and they just have a nose for the end zone, and that's Jerome Bettis. You saw the one earlier in the game, found his way in, going in backwards, but that one, he took on 3 guys and powered his way in for 6.
And we saw in the pregame show a week in the life of Jerome Bettis. How about a day in the life with 2 touchdowns in a big game to try to end the 3-game losing streak as Jeff Reed adds the extra point, who has scored 2 touchdowns, is in a tailback. Bettis getting the call, has an opening. Jerome Bettis regains his footing and will go out of bounds at the 36-yard line. 39 yards for Bettis, having a brilliant game today.
In a good look. I mean, look at the guys. One, two, three, four, five guys right there at the point of attack. And here comes Jerome Bettis right up the middle, right through all those defenders.
You know, with weather like this, guys, the advantage has to go to the team who has the running game already established, like Jerome Bettis.
First down and five after the penalty. Bettis, the big running back, remains in the game, gets the first down. Very tough to bring back under.
Make it back though.
Ron Haynes in the back, second down and 11, and the screen pass to Haynes. Green pass very effective on the first possession of the game for the Steelers. They get a first down here with 13 yards. With 8:24 remaining in the fourth quarter, here's Kyle Orton in trouble. Down he goes. Back.
5 yards at the line of scrimmage in depth and 1 yard outside each widest guy on the Steelers' offensive line.
Bettis will get another first down, driving the Bears back. You said it early. Showing blitz, and a pass thrown behind Gage, who came in incomplete. Bear team, and they did, taking the 7-0 lead on the first possession of the game. Jerome Bettis with the carry and gets the first down.
Kevin Santos on the special cam too there, Dick.
You did, and we thank him. Ball at midfield, and there is Jerome Bettis. Goes over 100 yards for the 61st time in his career. And right now, let's take a look at the NFC playoff picture. Bears managed one touchdown today. And Kyle Orton had one flash with two passes for 70 yards, setting up the touchdown. But Bill Cowher's Steelers come back against the Bears and end the Chicago 8-game winning streak in the process. And that's the story here in Pittsburgh.